Hello, everybody, and welcome to the nerd the gen what is it called again?
Nerdly gentleman.
Is nerdly a word?
Yes. If it's not, we just made it a word. If you say it enough, it's a word. So it's a word. Nerdly gentleman.
The Nerdly Gentleman podcast, everybody. So, a couple things are changing with the podcast. Why don't we just go over the few changes that are happening? A, the name, as we just stated. And two, you tell me about this idea because I'm totally just bringing this up, putting you on the spot with this idea right now. The way the podcast will now work is that we review things in genres instead of just unless something like comes up, in which case we would
Right.
do that. But so like this month I was thinking would be horror, and so next month would be whatever. And by the way, you can always comment what you want the next month to be, and we'll think about it. We probably will do it since we don't have anything else, any other ideas.
Most likely. We just sit here and we think of ideas, and they're not even good. So please comment.
We just twiddle our thumbs all day. We don't have anything really to do. What do you think
I
of that
mean,
idea?
sometimes we just stare at our monitors, but that's.
In silence too, like we don't speak, so we never know
Oh
when
no.
each other has
We're in a
left.
call. We just don't talk.
So we don't know when each other has
Yeah,
left. We just know that something's happening or that nothing's happening.
okay. All
Anyway,
right, so
so
do you want to discuss what we're talking about?
yeah, so well, first I wanted to talk about a little bit of news. I think we missed this last week, although I don't think you were on the podcast last week. Some photos,
I wasn't.
some photos for Doctor Strange, played by Benedict Cumberbatch, came out. Did you see those?
No, apparently they're good
Okay, look them up.
if you're bringing them up.
Look them up, because, dude, from the get-go, I knew Benedict Cumberbatch would be the best Doctor Strange. Because, I mean, dude, it's Benedict Cumberbatch. I mean,
I know. I've seen him in other films, but I haven't seen exact. I can't recall what he looks like exactly right now.
he's the guy in Sherlock, and he was also Khan in the latest Star Trek
Oh,
movie.
yeah.
Dude, he's such a fantastic actor too. I mean, he can play like, I just think he's a fantastic actor, really. I mean, he kind of plays a particular type of role, like he plays always the methodical smart guy. But I mean, there's a lot of actors, who just play like themselves, or either play themselves or play just one role. Like,
Oh, that's cool.
like Jesse Eisenberg basically is just, Mark Zuckerberg in every role. Anyway, so I just wanted to bring that up. What do you think about the photos? Hello? Hello? I believe that we are having technical difficulties. Oh no. Oh wait, are you there? Hello? Slow spawn. Are you there? So, slow spawn. Hello? Hello. Okay, I'm going to entertain everybody with my voice. Don't worry. I am here. And I am well. Are you there now?
Yay.
Okay, good.
Yeah.
Finally, I don't know what the heck just happened with you. I had to just sit here and entertain people with my voice while I replaced the batteries in my controller.
Oh, the poor people.
Thanks. But so what do you think of the photos?
Yeah, he looks like he'd make a great Doctor Strange because he looks really similar to the guy in the comics. So I don't
Something
think
that I
that'd be
heard
weird.
a bunch of people kind of complaining about was the fact that it looks too comic booky. Which, okay, most of the time people complain about how it doesn't look comic booky enough. Like, something like the Dark Knight trilogy, where it's like, oh, why does it have to be all gritty and realistic? Why can't it just be, like, why can't Batman wear like blue?
Yeah, well, I don't think there's such a thing as too comic booky.
Yeah, and I think it looks great. Especially for a dude who uses magic Why would you not make him look goof, colorful? Like, why would a magic dude have a dull outfit? It's just, I don't know. I think it looks fine. I don't think anybody should complain. I think it looks great. I'm sure the movie will be great too. Now, as I stated before, this month's genre of stuff we are reviewing, whether it be TV shows mo or movies or whatever, is horror. So why don't you tell everybody what it is that we are going to be reviewing this week?
We're going to be reviewing The Thing, and we
Yes.
just watched it, and it's scary.
And just to clarify, this is the 1982 version, directed by John Carpenter, because the remake was also called The Thing, and so I don't want to make people be like, oh, the 2011 remake, oh, that was garbage, ugh. Because that's naturally how I
Ugh.
think all people sound. But okay. And by the way, we're going to just spoil the heck out of this movie. Like, it was made in 1982. If you're gonna see it, go see it now. Like,
I mean,
we're not gonna wait for. Well, I mean, you can just pause this video, then go watch it. Then, but you go ahead, slow spawn. Say what it is that you wanted to say. Slow spawn.
oh.
Oh no, you're cutting out. Technical difficulties. Oh no.
Hello.
Good. Finally, you're back. I don't know what the
It
heck
doesn't
it was
take that
causing
long.
that. Yeah. Okay, so what were you gonna say?
For a 1982 movie, it's really good. But what I like the most is when you're looking at the creature, this is just me commenting about his appearance because I like to talk about that first. When he's morphing, you can see the faces of the other people he's been.
Oh
It's
yeah.
really
That's,
freaking
I
scary.
think here's the thing that I think is amazing is all of the detail people spent working on those effects. I mean, it looks really gory and stuff, but in some ways it's also kind of beautiful just how much like time and effort somebody spent on that, Like you can really tell somebody cared about making that thing look good. It wasn't like somebody was just like, "Hey, let's just, make it a weird dog thing. There we go." Like somebody really spent time and thought into making that. And I always value that in a movie. I always value whenever somebody puts thought and time into something because it really shows, especially in this movie. But yeah, what else can we talk about the appearance? You wanted to talk about the appearance, didn't you?
Yeah, it's like every time it morphs, it just gets bloody everywhere.
It really does. It's I gotta say,
I'm
if you're like I gotta say, if you're a squeamish
looking
person and
through
you haven't seen
pictures.
this, if you haven't seen this movie before, and you're not somebody who can take blood and gore very well, I suggest not watching this movie just because. I mean, it's a great movie. It's absolutely a great movie. It's just it's very, very gory. And something that's actually I wanted to talk about this when this first movie first came out. People really condemned this movie. Like people, like critics and audiences didn't like this movie at all because they thought, oh, this is just a gore fest. This is just, there's nothing special about it. But now it's thought of as like this is something you show in every single film class, Like it's up there now
Right.
with stuff like things. I
Well,
mean, I don't
what's.
necessarily know if you could put up there with things like Godfather and Pulp Fiction and things like that. I mean, you probably could. I think it depends on the person really if you like this movie. I think most people like this movie, but I think it takes it's a matter of opinion if you think, oh, this is one of the greatest movies of all time. I mean, it's certainly one of the best movies, one of the in the top like 100 movies of all time if you were to make a list like that. But yeah, is there anything you wanted to say about the effects?
The effects or the appearance of the creature, because that's a different topic.
That is true. I suppose just the appearance of it, and then we'll go on to the more of like the effects kind of stuff.
Okay. Well, I think I figured out like its basic body makeup, because it's pretty hard to tell throughout most of the movie, except for maybe around the end of it, but it can still be a little confusing. Basically, for those of you who have not seen this movie, since Hole Punch was too lazy to put up a picture
Teddy
of the
Jenkins.
thing, I will.
Remember. Okay, go ahead. Go ahead. Don't worry. Sorry. Hello. Hello. Oh no. Oh no, it's doing it again. I'm entertaining you with my voice now. Hooray, everyone. Well, this is going terribly, isn't it? La-di-da-di-da. Ha-ha. Ho-ho-ho. Hee-hee. Hee-hee-ho. Slow spawn, please get back here quickly. Ah, slow spawn. Slow spawn. Taking forever. Don't no, just skip a couple seconds into this and, it'll be perfect then. So, yep. Yep, yippity doo. Yippity doo, yippity doo, yippity doo. Totally just taking things into my own hands right now. Gonna call him on Skype. Pog. Get on Skype. This is all part of the show, everybody. Don't worry. Don't worry. All part of the show. So, yeah, the thing is truly a.
Okay, it says you're away. Can you hear me?
Yeah, I'm here. We should just do
Okay.
this on Skype. That way it'll be better. Yep, so I've just been entertaining people and it's all been part of the show, right? Slow
Yeah,
spawn.
no.
Right.
No, I've been listening to you. I can hear you when I'm trying to reconnect, and it's like, la-di-da-di-da. I must entertain you all with the sound of my voice. Yeah, I feel bad for your viewers. Anyways, jeez, dude. What, okay, so do the people, when they're taken over by the thing, do you think they still have like their brain? Like they're still thinking while it's overtaking them?
Let's. I want to just go over the appearance. I think I want to go to. Let's do it in sections because I don't want to go all over the place. But let's just finish it. I wanted to get on to the mechanics of how the creature works, in a second. You think we can? Can we finish up the appearance aspect of it first? Just that way, it's
Okay.
okay. Anyway, appearance wise. Okay, let's just say it looks. It looks really amazing. It looks. Stunning, this thing. This thing just looks. I mean, okay, I guess we'll go on to special effects since we pretty much talked about the appearance. Special effects wise, this thing looks amazing. I mean, this is like a masterpiece. I mean, this is a movie that every horror movie director should watch before making a horror movie. Like, it should be. Like a law that you need to watch
Well,
this movie.
they don't go by the natural horror movie rules. They don't have the black guy die at
Yeah.
first, because that's who dies like the first of every horror movie. We know
That
this.
is kind of true. But I will say though that this is why, okay, in horror movies, in pretty much everything, practical effects will always be better than CGI. No matter how far in the future it
Yeah.
gets. You'll always be able to tell when something's CGI. You can always tell. Even in something like Planet of the Apes. I mean, like, okay, Dawn of the Planet of the Apes, I could seriously believe that those are real apes running around because the CGI is so on point. But at the same time, you can still tell, it's CGI. Like, you're not thinking that, that's a puppet or something, or like that. That's it. Doesn't it? It doesn't look real, Like it looks real enough to where you're immersed in the movie, but there's a certain thing about practical effects that brings you into the world of the movie,
Right,
Like
but
it's a
hey, didn't they use like a lot of animatronics for doing a lot of
Oh
that practical effects stuff,
dude.
like especially the dog scene?
So I recently went to Universal Studios and they had a museum of special effects in like horror movies and well and not just horror movies but mostly horror movies. And they had the head crab thing from the thing there. They had the where the dude's head comes off and it turns like a weird crab.
Yeah.
They had that there. And dude, it was so amazing. It was so weird seeing it in like a little display case. And I'm like, wow, that was a thing in the movie and it looks just like it. And it's like it really helps you appreciate the fact that somebody handmade that thing. Like with their own two hands, somebody sat down, drew out a design of it, and just started making that thing. And they also had little like the little panel things that give you a little information in museums and stuff like that. They had a couple of those for it, and it was talking about how they had multiple different they had like several different animatronics. So they had like an animatronic for when the head pulls off of the guy, and they had animatronics for when the dog and every single thing that was in there had an, was an animatronic, I think. I mean, there were like puppets and things like that, but most of it was an animatronic, which is I just love the I love practical effects. I think practical effects are better than any other CGI you could make. Okay, so yeah. I guess, is there anything else you want to talk about the special effects? Hello. Hello. Really? Really? Okay, go into. No. Ah, slow spine. You make everything so difficult. Nope. No, I did not mean to do that. Da do 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 do. Go on Skype. Sound of my voice. Okay, so anyway, the thing is a that head crab thing looked really amazing just because of the all the little touches that were on it, all of the how the legs of it came out of the head and how they set it up to look like it really like it burst out instead of just attaching it to there and kind of putting some effects on it. It really looked amazing. I've been talking here about the head crab thing because of you. Just go on Skype. Skype doesn't do this.
I know, I'm on Skype. We can call it through there and end the session as it starts, so there's no double effect. But what
Okay.
I wanted to talk about was that giant crater that was in the Arctic when they're like discovering this ship, and they're like, oh, they dug this up, they used thermite. Oh, that's cool. I'm wondering how do you think they did that?
Oh, the giant crater in the Arctic. Could have been a set. If it was, it was a very big set. That's a good question. I was thinking about that too. I would think maybe they just went out to some big, like cold, snowy area and did that. But I mean, I don't know. They could have just, taken a normal area, then just like dug a little hole around it and put the, effects to make it look like a UFO, and then just put snow over it. Like fake snow. I mean, that's probably what they did. But I mean, I don't know. It could have been a number of things, really. Okay, Skype now, please.
See,
Okay,
I'll
good.
call you. Okay.
Okay, good.
Everything's better and everything's amazing. Awesome.
Yep. You can turn up your mic volume, by the way, because you're a little bit quiet. And also, I hear like a fan.
Okay, hold on. This is why I like curse. Is the fan gone?
No, but I think it'll be fine. I mean, it's fine, really. I mean, it's like super
I hate
small.
Skype. I hate
I'm
Skype.
so
I
sorry.
hate Skype.
But okay, so now I want to get on to the if how the just what is the thing in general. So we know it's an alien. So let's just go over what the thing is, just so we can figure this out easier. So the thing is an alien from somewhere. We don't know where. We just see its spaceship crashing. And we also know that it can take over. Now, okay, this is the thing that's sort of weird. What does the thing do to people? Because they really never quite explain how it works. You know what I mean? Like, does it. Okay, for instance, can there. Okay, help me out with this. Help me. Try to help me explain this. Okay? So can the. Does the thing just transform into other people after eating them? Or does it create, like, a clone? Or is it like it infects them and then. You know what I mean? Because they talk about it sometimes like it's a disease, but then other times they talk about it like it's a,
Parasite.
or is it, yeah, like it's a parasite, like it goes from one host to the other, or is it like, I mean, it like absorbs them, so is it like, is it just one, you know what I mean? Is it just one thing, or is it multiple? Is it like a virus and it's a like it's is it the is like the Borg, you know, where they're all connected? Because they say that in the movie that. You know, the life forms, even when they're separated, they still are connected to one another. But does that mean, like, for instance, all right, okay, let's say that at the end, which spoilers, as we said earlier, that at the end when it's
Yeah.
Mac and Childs there, is it if it is it could it be if it's both of them, like are they if they're both the thing, then does like you know what I mean? Do they both know that they're the thing? Are they just like, are they gonna fuse into one thing? You know what I mean? There's so many
My
questions.
gosh.
There's so many things that they don't explain in this movie, and I like
They
that,
don't ex
but
There's so many things they don't explain about the thing.
I
It's
know.
almost like the
That's
thing isn't a thing at all. It's just a thing.
but okay, what do you think? What do you think the thing is? And how it
I
works?
think it's some sort of alien parasite. What I think it does, it because when you look at the picture, well, not picture, but when you re do recall the clip of the bald guy, he was one of the first to turn. He ran outside into the snow. And the thing almost took him over, but it
But
didn't.
it had
Yeah.
like claws for hands and stuff, and he
It
had to
had claw
finish.
hands, and he was screaming. Yes. I'm recalling that. And basically, what I think it is, it's a parasite. I think it just morphs the body, though. It like replaces his cells with its cells.
But
And
here's
it's more like each cell is an organism itself, and that's how they infect other people. So it's almost like each cell is a parasite, but it can become one makeup just so it helps itself spread.
But here's the thing that made me kind of think that maybe that's not what it is, because that basically what that would be is it's if you're describing it more as a kind of a almost a shapeshifter. But I think that but if you notice in the beginning, it takes over two people. You know, when the dog goes into who is it again? Do we know who that is? Do we find out?
Oh.
Is it the guy whose chest opens up?
Yes.
Okay, I guess that must be who it is. Okay, see they're both infected at the same time, and we don't see. So we I guess it must be that it's like a disease, that what it does is it. See, that's the thing I wonder. Okay, is it if it's a disease, then why does it need to like eat a person? You know what I mean? Why does it not just like go
I
like.
think it just needs a host to survive, but that's why I called a parasite because it needs the host to survive. At
Yeah.
least I think so.
But it's also multiple different things. You know what I mean? That's why I think it's not necessarily just a parasite, because it can have multiple hosts. You know what
Right.
I mean? So maybe it's like Maybe we're thinking of this in the wrong the wrong idea of it's one thing. I think we got to look at it more like I said before, like the Borg. You know, like there's multiple different of it's multiple parts, but they are one being. You know what I mean? Like maybe it's like okay, the guy whose chest opens up, I can't remember his name, and the bald guy at the beginning, maybe they are connected the entire time, and maybe we don't see the guy whose chest opens up. I can't remember if he's there or not, but I'm thinking that probably it's like a parasite, like you said, that it needs a host, but it's not like it's just one creature. It's not a creature. It's like it's a hive mind kind of parasitic
Right.
entity sort of thing. So I think we were both sort of right, but I think it's the idea that it's not one being. I think it's like it is one being, but it can have multiple different hosts. I think that's why they kind of refer to it as almost as like a disease, because it can have infest it can infect people, you know? So I would imagine that's probably what it is. But so you said before that are there brains in there? So do you mean like are they still conscious within it? Like does their
Yes.
consciousness become a part of? So that's an interesting question, because that would lead to kind of it being very similar to like the Borg, where like they are one consciousness, you know, and like they are each a part of the one consciousness. Not the thing that would lead us to believe that that's correct is when they're doing the blood test and they hit, you know, they burn one dude's blood and then he turns because he feels the pain too. I would imagine that maybe that would mean that all of them are connected physically and mentally, right? Like
Right.
that would appear to be the case. So what do you think? You think that they're all
Yeah,
connected?
I think it's. I think each cell itself is almost as like a living organism. Like, obviously, cells are technically alive, but what I mean is, each cell, like you said, is like a hive mind, and it takes over like a parasite. But the only reason it does its shape shifting thing is more so for just so it can feed on others, because this thing
Yeah,
obviously
cause
can't live on its own. That's why it's taking over other
yeah,
things.
cause I mean, I think the whatever it is, the like program that shows a simulation of what the cells do, where it shows one cell infecting another, then it turns to look like that cell. I think that's the idea, is that it's just that on a bigger scale of the reason for it turning into it is so that way it can just blend in to infect more. I think that's the thing, is that it's more like a disease that is conscious. Like it's like a conscious disease that can think, you know? Like it can it and its primary goal is to just infect more. Because that's ultimately what a disease's goal is to just infect more as much as it can.
I really want them to make a movie where it's like, if the thing came to like America and it's basically spreading and all that, and it basically can do sort of an origin story.
That would be interesting.
That like it explains more about the thing, how it works and where it came
Yeah.
from, how it got here, why it came here.
I think an interesting idea. Here's the thing I love most about this movie is that it's really a movie that you can really relate to, because of the way that like everyone can relate to the fear of isolation and the fear of being trapped and not knowing what's going to happen. You know, just the general idea that I'm totally like no one's coming. You know, like in the whole movie you feel all the characters' fear and anxiety. Like I
Yeah.
mean, 'cause they go crazy. And you know what, and there's no point at the in during the movie in which I think you and I, at least you and I, were like there's no way that person would go crazy. There's no, you know, there's no reason, 'cause I mean if there's a thing that can just look like anyone and it like eats you and then creates a clone of you, of course you're gonna go crazy. And if you're, especially if you're in Antarctica, where there is no help, there's no, you know,
It's always cold.
there's no government coming to save you, there's no cops. It, like, you are it. You know, like, you're just, like, whatever help's gonna come, it's gonna come from you. That's it. There's no. I mean, I think everyone can relate to that idea of being alone and being scared, you know?
Well, I like that final scene where it's I know. I like that final scene where it's they're talking at or no,
Yeah.
yeah, sorry. I'm sorry. I'm procrastinating. But they were talking and they were in the dude's hut and they see him run like somewhere else because he shut off the power so that they would freeze and they're like he just wants to freeze. He doesn't want to fight. He'll wait till the rescue team and then he'll move to like North America or whatever.
Yeah.
And they basically just turned into like selfless, awesome dudes. And they're like, all right, let's kill everything. And they get like all the dynamite out and they start torching everything.
Well, that.
It's probably the coolest part.
Yeah. Although I don't necessarily think that they were being selfless. I don't think it was the idea of, you know, let's be heroes. I think it was the idea of, I don't want any living thing to ever see this again. You know? Like, I think it was the idea of,
Are you there?
I'm. Yeah, I'm here. Can you hear me? Hello?
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 Yeah, I'm here. I'm here. I'm here.
Okay.
It was just a small crash.
Okay. Well, I was saying that I think it's the I don't think they were necessarily being selfless, like you know, the idea of let's be heroes to, you know, save the world or whatever. I think it was the idea that they were thinking, I don't want any human being to ever see this thing again. I don't want any a single living being ever have to come in contact with this thing ever again because of all the suffering that I've had to do. And I also think they knew ahead of time they're gonna die. You know, like they like the place is so messed up that there's no way they can just. I think also a part of it is that they don't want to live anymore. Just the idea
Well, I
of
think it was they don't. No, I don't think it's they don't get to live anymore. They knew they were gonna freeze. They're like, all right, so we
yeah.
either just all freeze to death and let this thing freeze with us until the rescue team comes, and then it'll infect others, or we can burn everything and have an awesome time and look like superheroes.
But
Gold option two.
I think also that a big part of it was the fact that I mean, they're insane at this point. You know, like they've gone mentally insane by this time, really. Because I mean, and also like I said before, I think a big part of it is the fact that they don't really want to keep going.
Right.
You know, I think they're really, at this point, I think most of all, you'd be tired. Not, and I'm not talking like physically tired. I just mean like in a more spiritual kind of way. You're just like tired of living at this point. Like you don't want to see, like you know, like there. I think that at the same time you think, how can I just go back to life? You know, how can I ever live a normal life knowing that, you know, like there's something like there might be a whole planet of these things somewhere,
Right.
and
Like they're
they.
gonna have PTSD like super hard.
Yeah, I mean you would have to. I mean, you've killed your best friends, you know? Like people that you've been stuck more than best friends, dude, 'cause you know, you think about it, these people are like live together. Like they breathe the same air as one another. Like they hang out with each other every single day. You know? Like they eat and just I mean, they're always together with these guys and then they have to kill them. You know?
Well, I remember one part in the movie. He's like, "What? You're gonna burn Tom? I've known him for 10 years. He's my friend." He's like, "We can't let these things survive," and he just walks away.
Yeah. I mean, and that's the thing is that kind of some characters realize, you know, that's not him anymore. And that's the thing. And some
Right.
of but others are
Like Tom's
like
dead.
yeah. And then some are like, you know, like I can't do this. You know, like Clark, I think it is, the guy who's the dog keeper. He you know, he I think he most of all just doesn't like this whole situation. Not in the
Well,
way
his
that, you
dogs
know,
died. Oh, crap.
I mean, And dude, just I mean, ultimately, okay, Blair was really smart when you think about it. Like I wonder how things would have turned out if they had all listened to Blair in the beginning and just been like, okay, yeah, let's do an interrogation right now. Nobody's getting out of
No,
sight.
Blair wanted to kill everyone.
That's true. That is technically true. But you know what I
Oh, let's
mean.
listen to Blair. Let's let him shoot me in the face.
Yeah, but I think that
Let's
was
go listen to
because
Blair.
I think that was though because he got it. Like he understood what they understand at the end, that we just can't, we gotta do whatever it takes to not let this thing leave. Like it can't leave, otherwise the world is gone. Like it's over. Like it's game over, man, game over.
Right.
Like I mean, like that's it. They're just, I mean, by the end of the movie, they realize they're just done. Like there's no, because I think that, and that's one thing I think a lot of horror movies do incorrectly, where it's like, I suppose that in other horror movies, like there's always a chance the characters can live,
Well, under
but I.
most circumstances, but under mo but in most horror movies, you're not in the middle of freaking
That's
Antarctica.
very true. That's very true. Like there's always a, like the reason that many horror movie characters are always selfish is because they think, at least I'll make it. At least I can make it, Like the idea, like okay, in like Alien, in Aliens or Alien, most of those guys are completely selfish because they're like, well, no, I'm gonna let you die, man, because, there's a ship, I can get to it and leave, like it. But it, when you're in Antarctica, you can't walk anywhere. There's zero chance of you getting somewhere. Like it's just, if you don't have place to live and some food and water to last you a long time, and somebody coming for you, you're just dead,
How bad do you think the PTSD is of those freaking dogs? I mean, I almost feel good that they got killed because they got put out of their misery. They
Dude,
almost
okay,
got.
though I gotta say that dog scene is absolutely terrifying. Just because, now here's the, you know what? We were watching this movie and you asked me why it was that I said that the scene with the dog, the dog just stare, just not doing anything was so scary. But you gotta think about it, like it really is a really good imagery right there, because it's showing that dog's not normal. 'Cause he all he's doing is just staring at the wall. And all the other dogs are just hanging out with each other, sleeping. Like it's like, but him, he's just staring at the wall. Like, and you can really see, almost see that he's planning something. Like he's getting ready to do something. You know what I mean?
Right.
Like he's, 'cause this entire time, he's smart. Like they show several times that this thing's smart. That's why it cuts off the power, so that way it can freeze and just wait for somebody else to come,
Breaks the
fall.
helicopter.
Yeah. Breaks the, well, that's a good qu part about a good question. Now, when Blair destroyed the helicopter and the radio, do you think that was Blair or that was the thing? Like, do you think the thing was like, I want to be here because I can survive the cold? And also, like, did you think it wanted to get out, or that it wanted to stay in so it could infect all of them, and then none of them could get away? Because they kind of make you, they never really make it clear if it's the thing. Like that's one thing that's really good about this movie, is that you never know at which point who's infected, which when did this guy become infected, or when did this guy become infected? It's kind of left unclear, so that you can sort of just guess.
I'm sure people like try to put it all together in their theories, but nothing's set in stone, you know?
But when did you think that Blair became infected? Like, did it?
I think it was after they started to do it around when they started doing the blood test. I think
Yeah, when he
maybe,
was.
yeah, because he wasn't acting weird until around that. Well, maybe because he's like, it's cold out here. I want to be let inside, but I
That's
don't know.
that that could it, you could say though that was because he was hopped up on morphine.
Right.
So do you think that he was infected when he destroyed the helicopter and the tractor and all the other stuff.
No, I think he was just losing his mind because he knew he was gonna die.
Yeah, because he was really the ultimately the guy who knew first that, we're all gonna die. Like, there's
Some of y'all
zero
don't know
chance
what's
of.
going on, but I do, and I ain't sure, and I sure as heck can't stay here and find out what's gonna happen. He should have just let took the helicopter and left.
But I think though that you gotta remember, he's the scientist guy. He's the one who's supposed to, study things and solve the problems of the world. Like a scientist's goal is to understand the world. So I think that his thing was that he understood this. And I mean, he had that whole simulation going of how long until if this thing gets civilization, how long before it infects the entire world. And it's like 27,000 hours, which is, well, that's like less than a year, right? 27,000 hours. I would imagine, right?
Yeah, I think that's
That's probably
yeah.
about less than a year. So I mean, if you're a scientist and you know that, and you're a real, like you profoundly believe that science is, the answer to everything, as many scientists do.
Right.
I think you're just gonna be like, okay, for the betterment of humanity, no one can leave. These five, like these, nine people or whatever, all have to die, because there has to be a 0% chance that this thing leaves. But dude, this is. I think that one thing I really appreciate about this movie is that the director really knew what he wanted to make, and
Oh,
he
yeah.
just like he knew from the get-go, like, we're not making, like, it wasn't like he just kind of made it up as he went along, like, okay, this looks good for this and this looks good for this. He like handcrafted every single shot, every single scene to do something to build the movie better, which I love seeing in a movie. Because it makes me realize that, A, this person spent a lot of hard work and time and thought into making this movie as good as it could be. And also, it shows they really cared about what they were doing. Like, I think there's a lot of directors who don't care about the movie they're making. Like, they just want to make this movie so that way their career can be furthered.
Right.
But I love seeing a director make the movie he wants to make. Not, I like it when a director has no regrets about the movie he made, which is exactly what I think this is. This is a movie about where a director made the, like, okay, you can tell that there was no like third party that said, we should have the weird dog mutant garbage gore monster thing.
Right.
Like, it takes a creative mind to be like, yeah, let's put that in the movie. Because that's what the director's job is to say, hey, let's put this in the movie. Let's not put this in, and let's change this, and that sort of thing.
Right. And he did a really good job of that, I think.
He really
Oh, by the
did.
way, we're almost up on time.
Okay, we can go a little bit further. But I do want to say that John Carpenter is a brilliant director. He absolutely is. And
Yeah,
he's made
didn't
a.
he also do Halloween?
He also did Halloween, which is
That's what he's
another.
known for.
Which is another really great example of a great movie he's done. He's also made Escape from New York, which I haven't seen that before. I've heard it's. I think it's supposed to be good. And he also made Big Trouble in Little China, which I love that movie. Other people hate it, but I mean, it ultimate. Okay, we'll do that movie whenever, like, the comedy genre. When we start reviewing comedies. Oh man, reviewing comedies. That'll be crazy time.
Well, all that's gonna happen is I'm just gonna like re-say every joke. Be
Yeah,
like,
be
oh
like,
yeah,
oh
and then he
man.
said, nope.
Yeah.
Right.
Well, that's kind of the only way that you can really review a comedy. Like, there aren't a whole lot of ways to
You can talk
review a
about plot.
comedy. Wait, what'd you say?
You can talk about plot a little bit. Maybe some of
That's
the dynamic of how the characters work together and some of the acting. That's all I can think of then.
Now there is one final thing though that we gotta talk about.
What?
The ending.
Who was
Because
it? Who was the thing?
so let's just, if for those of you who don't know and don't care about spoilers, the ending is supposed at what we see, Kurt Russell, Mac, escapes the explosion, killing the thing, and he sits down. And he's super tired and is like, you know, is ready to accept the fact that he's gonna totally die. Because the entire camp is blown up. And Childs comes by and is like, hey, you know, I was chasing Blair and I saw him go out into the storm, so I decided to go after him, but I got lost in the storm. And so now I'm here. Is it dead? Good. Let's just, you know, sit down. And it's left with the idea of you don't necessarily know if one, both, or none of them are infected still.
Who was the
Because
second guy you mentioned? I always forget the names.
Childs.
Okay, so let me say, Giles changed clothes from the last time we saw him, so I think it's
Well,
him.
okay,
That that's.
I went back and looked. He doesn't change clothes. What happens is that he's covered in snow the next time we see him. Because he was out in the storm. So it's just, it's like, it's white. Because of the fact that it's covered in snow. Now, there's many theories about who is infected or who is not infected. Supposedly, this is what supposedly John Carpenter has said, and this is like a guy said that John Carpenter said on Reddit, you know, like that it's obviously Kurt Russell is the human. Because if you look at the footage, Childs, you know, like, okay, Kurt Russell, you know, is breathing, you know, really heavily and stuff like that. You know, you see the breath coming off of them. And with Childs, you don't see that. Which means that he's obviously the thing because the thing doesn't breathe. However, here's the thing I gotta say is that this is what makes me think that John Carpenter didn't really say this, is that I looked at it and you can see Childs breathing. But also, you gotta take into account the fact that there's wind. So it could have just been the fact that, because if you notice, Kurt Russell's breathing like there's like fog coming out of his mouth practically, and that would mean that the wind is hitting the back of him, blowing the air forward to make it appear bigger, which means that Childs, it would go, you know, in his face, so it wouldn't be as noticeable. So that's what I think. The other theory is that it's Kurt Russell because the thing cannot replicate non-organic materials like Child's earring that he has.
Right.
Which I don't know. Maybe that's true. Maybe it isn't. Although there's also the chance that none of them could be infected. You know, that they all just made it out of there happily ever after. Well, not happily ever after because they freeze to death ultimately.
They don't make it out to begin with. They just sit there and they die.
What do you think? What's your theory?
That was my theory. You just poked a hole in it, so thank you.
I'm
No,
sorry.
I think they're both human because they didn't start attacking each other. If one of them was the thing, I think it would have sensed the other one wasn't, would have killed them. If both of them were the thing, maybe they were. That could have been it,
If,
or
well,
both
here.
human. I think it's either they're both human or they're both the thing. That's all I can say.
Well, here's the thing I think is that if both of them were the thing, then you'd think they wouldn't even speak to one another. That they'd just like, okay, let's fuse together now. You know, like they wouldn't be like, hey, did you kill it? Yep. You know, like they wouldn't be pretending to one another. You know? Like that wouldn't quite make sense. However, here is ultimately, I think, here's what I think. Either Kurt Russell is infected or none of them are infected, and here's why. Because Childs is the one with the flamethrower. And Kurt Russell doesn't have a flamethrower. So if one of them was infected, so let's say, all right, that you know, Childs is infected. He is a flamethrower. He would just kill Kurt Russell.
Right.
Although, I suppose you could argue it doesn't want to kill people, it wants to infect them. Still, I think that the thing would be smart enough to go, I can just kill this dude and be fine, versus risk death, you know?
Right, because there's still a flamethrower. It could explode, kill them both if he has a gun or something. You don't know.
Yeah. He even has a whiskey bottle. So he could do, you know, he who knows? He could probably throw it at the flamethrower and make it go all over and, you know. So if it was, so you know, naturally, if it was Kurt Russell, that would be the reason for him faking it, because he doesn't want to get burned, you know, because he doesn't want to get, you know, killed. Or the other option is, you know, none of them are infected and they're totally fine. It's really hard to say which one is right though. Maybe none of them are right. Maybe it's just up to you. You know, maybe it's like the in Pulp Fiction, the briefcase of, you know, what's in the briefcase? Oh, it's whatever you want. Have you seen Pulp Fiction, by the way? Oh, dude, that movie's so great. That's one of my that might be my favorite movie of all time.
We can talk about it
I know, I
later.
know. But so yeah, so if you were to give this a score, what would you give it? I guess we'll do a score.
Like, okay, so 5 stars or like 1 to 10?
1 to 10, I think is the
1 to 10?
best.
Ten?
Yeah.
That's more specific, so I suppose you're right. Considering when it was made, I'd say a 9.5, because it's not, obviously it's not perfect, but it's a really, really good movie and I
Yeah.
really enjoyed it.
Yeah, I would say that I would agree with you. I would say 9.5 too. I would say that this is the okay, no movie is perfect.
Right.
There's never going to be a movie that's
Well, besides Batman v Superman, but you know,
Yeah.
that's given.
Absolutely.
And maybe the new Star Wars.
But there are certain movies I think that could be qualified as perfect as a movie could get. You know? Like I would classify Pulp Fiction as being one of those. That's, you know, as perfect as it can get. And I would classify this as being in that category too. So I would say that I would give it a 9.5. You would also give it a 9.5. That is the podcast, I suppose, isn't it? So thank you everybody for watching the Nerdly Gentleman podcast. I'm your host, Teddy Jenkins, and with me is my co-host, Suspawn.
Yes.
We will see you next week when we review another horror thing, which, by the way, put a link in the script or, you know, whatever, some kind of thing that you want us to review
Buy.
next week. Yeah.
Purchase. Waste our money on.
Yeah, waste more of our money on. Maybe we'll do like a TV show next week.
Yeah.
That'll be a cool idea. All right, well, thank you, and goodbye.